Hi, this is Trevor Paulson from Adobe Analytics Product Management, and I'm excited to demo today some of the cool new features we've added for Attribution IQ to Analysis Workspace. To start, I'm going to add my marketing channels to my table, along with my success event, which is orders. The thing that we've added that's new is the ability to change the attribution model at the column level. I can now change my attribution model to be a non-default attribution model. When I select this checkbox, I've got a whole bunch of new options that I've never had before. I can change attribution to be last touch, first touch, linear, and participation, which are models we've always supported in ad hoc analysis, but now support in Workspace. In addition to that, I can now do models like same touch, U-shaped, which gives 40% to the first and last and 20% shared, J-curve and inverse J, which are similar with a little more weighting to first or last, a time decay model that allows me to specify the half-life decay, as well as a custom model that lets me specify my own weights. So I might specify 10, 80, and 10s. We also support two look-back windows, both of which are configurable, a visit look-back window and a visitor look-back window. When I hit apply, we update this report to reflect the new attribution model. It's very responsive, and I can actually do this as many times as I want and compare as many attribution models as I want simply by editing that model that I showed before. I can choose linear, for example, to compare to the other attribution models I've selected. There's no limit to the number of models that you can compare. And in fact, you can even compare using segments. So if I wanted to apply a segment of tablet customers, those models will now be filtered down to just my tablet customers. Or if I wanted to compare specific products, I can very easily do that as well. By comparing my boots and my parka, I can compare how these two products perform by any attribution model that I want, seeing how many orders I got by channel for each product. Additionally, we also support breakdowns. Breakdowns are a way that I can dive in deeper to any of my marketing channels that I've selected. So, by simply dragging that in, I can break down the channel by the channel detail, giving me the individual tracking codes that each marketing channel has within it, as well as the performance of each of those individual campaigns with each model applied at the campaign level. Additionally, I can specify an attribution model at the breakdown level. So if I wanted to distribute these 63 boot orders using a different model just for email, I can very easily do that by simply editing the breakdown attribution model. This is really useful for teams that have their own method of attribution or think of attribution in their own way, who want to be able to take a fancier model but break it down by a less sophisticated model or vice versa. Additionally, attribution models can be applied to any dimension, including props, EVARs, classifications, or any of our out-of-the-box dimensions. So, for example, I can take our page type variable, which is a prop, drag that in, and my attribution models will also be reflected for any variable. So this means you can apply attribution models to things like page types, to individual marketing campaigns. I can do it even with internal promotions or search terms. So there's lots of really cool ways that you can now apply attribution models in ways that you haven't been able to do before. So that's Attribution IQ in Freeform Tables, and good luck.